Now, before I begin, I'd like all of you to look under your seats and see if there's a printed piece of paper there. So let's get moving, everybody. And if you have that piece of paper, then why don't you raise it up high for everyone to see? Well, there's supposed to be more, but nothing goes as planned. So, if they were raised, you'd see the numbers 1, 3, 3, and 1. Now, these numbers may be recognized by some of you due to your early math classes. However, to the unenlightened, these numbers correlate to the fourth row of Pascal's triangle. If you look at the fourth row, we can see the numbers 1, 3, 3, and 1. But I'm going to move on, because I want you to look at math as more than a triangle with figures on it. I want you to look at math as more than 6x squared plus 6x is equal to 5. I want you to look at math as the foundation of our universe. As every strong building has a solid foundation, every discovery and invention we make also has a foundation, and that's math. And Galileo said it best, sorry about that. Oops. Mathematics is a language with which God has written the universe. Now, in order to explain this better, I'm going to bring up an example, something that may have happened to some of you. Now, I'm sure there's some people here who've heard of the term overbooking. For those of you who haven't, it's simply when businesses overbook, for lack of a better term. This usually happens in the flight industry, when airlines sell more tickets than they have seats. Now, I don't know why they do this. Maybe they finally let us sit on the outside of the plane. Would you look at that? They even give you a complimentary drink. Now, as fun as that would be, that's unfortunately not the case. Now, let's have a show of hands. How many of you here have missed a flight before? It can be for any reason, but if you've missed a flight, raise your hand. That's a large percent of you. I guess I should be buying you guys alarm clocks. Well, you people missing your flights is exactly what airlines bet on. You see, not everyone can show up 5 hours early before their flight or read 24-hour time format. And so, they miss their flights. And this data is saved. And so airlines can see this data, analyze this data, and once they do, maybe you'll tell them that, hey, only 90% of your passengers are going to show up for your 3 a.m. flight to the Democratic Republic of Congo. In which case, they start thinking, why are we losing out money here? We paid for the fuel, the food, the drinks, depending on the airline, of course. So they think, how can we change that? And they do that simply by selling more seats. Now, in the case that everybody does show up and they have sold more seats, of course, some people have to be booted off the flight. And there are costs of this. They have to pay for connecting flights, overnight hotel stays, or anything else that comes up. And so airlines obviously aren't going to bet on the ridiculously small chance that nobody shows up for their flight and they sell 100% extra tickets and earn a lot more money. So this is where the math comes in, with a magic number telling them how many seats they should sell. Now, let's go back to Pascal's triangle for a second. But let's take a look at the third row this time. 1, 2, 1. More of you may recognize this number. This is what we use to create something called a binomial. And we further use that to create something called a binomial distribution, which tells you exactly how likely a certain scenario is to happen. And in this case, it would be how likely it is for a certain number of passengers to show up to your flight. So airlines, they create this graph, they analyze the data, they calculate how much revenue they would get, how much loss, how much profit they'd get for every scenario of how many people would show up to their flight. And then they pick the scenario that earns them the most profit, whilst is also the most likely. However, sorry, cut that off. In any case, they sometimes only earn a few thousand dollars. In the span of one flight, that's not a lot, but airlines have millions of flights, and that multiplies yearly. So $1,000 multiplied by millions of flights, multiplied by 2, 3, 4, 5 years, that multiplies to an enormous amount of revenue over time. So maybe don't miss your flight next time, or some poor dude's gonna get kicked off of his because you missed yours. In any case, I went on a bit of a larger tangent than I meant to with that one. I guess you could say I put a TED talk in my TED talk. However, I want you to look at math as more than just complex equations and triangles that may have numbers in them time to time. Because you see, math is a cornerstone of innovation, and it leads to a crossroads of endless possibilities and opportunity. Like Galileo said best, each one of us holds within us the key to unlocking the mysteries of the universe simply by discovering the foundation that it's all based off of. So as you leave today's halls, I want you to think of math as more than a mere subject. I want you to think of it as an idea, a concept, a gateway, if you will. So embrace it, for within its embrace, we have the key to unlock the mysteries of our universe.